We start with you, and then we move to...
Just introduce your name, when you started the course, what the name of the course, and the process that it takes.
Okay. I am Mr. Okuti Lucky Idafi. DSTV installation is a very important short course for our youth, in that if they partake in it, they can enjoy good benefits from it. They can be self-sustained and they can earn a living from it. The material components you are seeing here is for DSTV installation. The component I'm holding is a DSTV parabolic dish or reflector. It is mounted up on the building wall where there are no obstructions. On the DSTV parabolic dish, we have two components there. We have the feed on. This is the feed on, popularly known as a collector, that collects the signals reflected by the parabolic dish. The feed on is technically placed at the focal point of this parabolic dish, such that parallel rays of signals that are reflected by this parabolic dish will converge at this, at that point, at the focal point where the feed on is. And by so doing, the feed on will collect and trap the signals and pass the signals to another component called the LMB. This is the LMB at the back of the feed on. Now, this signal haven't traveled very far, for far distance. Must have encountered dust particles in the atmosphere and as such become weak and contain unwanted signals. The NMB will amplify the signals, filter the unwanted signal, and send it via Kuasa cable to the indoor receiver or decoder. This box here is called a decoder or the indoor receivers. The decoder will convert the received signal back to audio and video format, which cannot be viewed on the television set. Now, we'll see how we install the DSTV in a particular building. Okay? Now, mount the dish. First, we'll mount the parabolic dish at the mounting point up here.
So this is the dish. After the assembly, we take it up to the mask. We can track by two ways, either using a sat meter or we use a manual tracking where you connect your signal to your decoder through the quasar cable, a DC quasar cable down to the decoder to start your tracking. Here is a sat meter which we are going to use to track the DSTV signal. Already here is the frequency and the symbol rate for DSTV. For DSTV, the central frequency we are using now is 11747, and the symbol rates 27,500, polarity horizontal, which is already imputed into the sat meter. So after the assembly, we'll take it up there to the mask, where we can now position it at an angle that to be in line of sight with the satellites up there, using the sat meter, the signal finder, to track the DSTV signals. So let's take it to the mask now, where we'll do the tracking.
Maybe
you should go to that angle.
Okay.
From this side, you come now.
My colleague is up there trying to mount the parabolic dish and the LMB to track the DSTV signal. So as you can see, he's trying to tie the knot so that I can tie the parabolic dish to the very stand there. So I will be able to track the signal from this very place to the decoder. As you can see now, he's trying to tie the parabolic dish to the mounted pole. So I will be able to control the panel and track the signal for upward view.
Yeah, but we do have one common problem I noticed here. That when you change the CCTV, before you know it, there's something wrong with the connection, and then you have to call them again to connect it or do something with the when they come, different people come and they complain of the previous the people that came before that they didn't fix it well, they should have tightened it here. How do you make provision for all those? Because that is where expertise comes into play. So why, what is that they were supposed to do that they are not doing?
Yes, there are limitations to the operation of the DSTV. Now, weather condition is one of them. And when talking about weather, talking about rain and stormy weather. When it rains, the signals will get mixed with water droplets in the atmosphere. And that will weaken the signals and get the signal become morphed. Okay? And when the signal is morphed, you have a very poor quality image on the TV set. So what we do, we make sure that the parabolic dish is firmly tightened to the wall, so that when it's storming or it's raining, there will not be a displacement of the parabolic dish pan. Because once the pan is displaced, the signal will be lost. Until you have to climb up and go back there again to reposition the dish towards the maximum signal strength. So as you align itself, we line on sight of the signal so that signal can be restored. Another thing is that when you have windy condition, the NMB cable tend to go off. The reason is that the installer probably did not tighten the NMB cable properly to the NMB. So when there is wind, tendency is that the NMB cable can be blown off.
What is the LMB?
The NMB cable, that's the coaxial cable, can be blown off. And once that is done, signal will be lost. So during installation, we make sure that the NMB cable is properly tightened to the NMB, so that when there is wind, the chances that the NMB cable will be thrown off will not be there. It will be very, very reduced. So by so doing, the signals received will be strong and will have a better quality picture.
He connected the coaxial cable, as we said earlier, to the NMB, to the satellite meter on his hand. He's trying now to track the signal from the atmosphere, because he told you just now, earlier before now, that there are two methods of tracking the signal. You either do it manually from your TV set, you connect the coaxial cable from the LMB to your TV set, you turn while you try to get the signal. But then now he has a DSTV satellite meter. He doesn't need to go to the television again. From the one on his hand there, he can easily turn, check. Once he gets the frequency, he will then come down, connect the coaxial cable to the decoder. So the decoder cannot transform the received signal into audio and video signal. Thank you.
So what he's trying to do, he's trying to track the signal. using that sat meter on his hand there. So once that's, once the signal is being tracked, okay, then it will now tighten the parabolic dish very well, firmly to that holder, so that there will not be shaking or wavering of the parabolic dish. It will come down before we now go to the indoor unit to continue the other process of the installation. So until you finish the tracking, we can't go to the indoor unit.
Oh, clear.
So what it's doing now, it's like it has gotten the signal now. What it's doing now, it's trying to ensure that the signal strength is improved, so that by the time we go to the indoor unit, we'll have a better quality picture. That's what it's trying to do, to improve the quality of the signal received.
The sat meter is beeping, giving us a sound, showing that it has locked the particular DSTV signal. It's making some sound. So after the signal, we're now attached the quasar cable, ROG6, to the LMB now. Facing the DSTV satellites. So we did can connect this one to our decoder to get the picture and the sound. So at the back of the decoder we have the LMB in, the ROF in, and the ROF out. This is the LMB in, we screw this one to the LMB in. To the LMB in. Then this is the video cord that will take the picture and sound down to the television. Then we can now power on the television and put it on AV. We also have another code here for
students studying abroad. According to that report in 2014, 25.5% of Chinese university students abroad chose to major in business.
Since the signal is already attached to the decoder, it has converted it to picture and sound. It's already showing now with the help of our sat meter. So we can now just do the manual settings to check the quality of signal by going to the menu and down to settings.
Students from China are pursuing an education abroad at ever younger ages. Data shows that last year, Chinese students under the age of 18 made up close to a quarter of all Chinese students studying in the UK. And the number of Chinese middle and high school students studying in the US. For education and opportunity.
Elected Chinese could attain. The bright and the best were sent abroad with government funding, so they could come back with much needed skills and knowledge.
And you know, DSTV is a DTH, direct to home decoder. that subscription, you cannot watch DSTV. It's a premium package that you have to subscribe first because you can watch every other stations. Although this is the footage we have on DSTV, the CCTV, the channel network. It's the one that's only free to the DSTV network. But for that to, for you to watch every other channels, you need to subscribe before you can watch every other channels like sport channels, CNN, BBC, and all the rest of the channels. You have to subscribe. Okay? That's all for the DSTV.
For the operation to be successful, there are key points we must note. One, the DSTV dish must point at a particular direction to be able to receive proper, better quality pictures. That direction, we have the azimuth of 81.5 degrees, and we have an elevation of 36.1 degrees. We must point parabolic dish at this direction. And the DSTV signals is actually a radio frequency signal. And the frequency of that signal is about 11,747 gigahertz. They will have a symbol rate. That is the speed at which the signals is being received.
All right. I understand what you're saying. But do you understand what he's saying?
Yeah, of
course. What is he saying? Just help him complete it.
Okay, that's what he said, that for the satellite to work perfectly or properly, it must have been, it has to be positioned at a particular angle, which you just mentioned, at 81.5 angle degree. So for you to be able to watch a better quality picture. So that's in other words, if the dish is not pointed to that angle, that means the quality of your signal, of your picture, will be watching, will be very low. So that's why that's with the help of this meter we just used, so you can actually locate the angle and the direction at which the dish will face. So by so doing, since that, you're able to get a well or a good proper quality of picture you are going to watch your home.
Okay. All right. Okay. Now we understand that you guys are DSTV installers, right? You've just displayed the technical aspect. Have you been taught the business aspect?
Yeah, sure.
I understand that you people have been taught the business aspect.
Yeah.
And you can be a DSTV expert, but how do you monetize it? That again is another problem. How do you drive the monetization? How do you make money out of it? If you are a DSTV installer, do you believe that you can just stay in your house and make money? Or you have to go out there and let people know that yes, you can install DSTV, and your DSTV, installation of DSTV has a different from the other people? That is the monetization aspect, the business aspect. And we also know that there are challenges to face that will come our way when we go out onto the wide world and want to do these things. I must say that I'm very happy. I'm proud. I believe now that this is just about giving you a job. You might not officially be having a job now, but you can be self-dependent, self-employed, or you could work for a company. And so, these guys are out there. All you need to do is to grab it one way or the other. Isn't it?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
All right, gentlemen, congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
We'll be meeting again.
Thank you, sir.